Okay, today we're going to show you how to change elements in three different filters here. This is a base-mounted pressure filter. This is an in-tank return line filter, and this is a T-ported pressure filter or low-pressure filter. Before we start this, and of course we're doing this in a studio, if you're doing it on your machinery, you're going to have some rags, and you're going to have a can of some sort, or a canister or a pan, to take the old element and catch any residual oils. And try to be as clean as you possibly can when you're doing this, not to induce more dirt into the system. The GRTB is an in-tank mounted return line filter. It can handle flow ratings up to 100 gallon per minute and operating pressures up to 100 PSI. We're going to show you how to change this in-tank filter. Of course, as you can see, it's not in a tank, it's sitting on a table. But it's very simple to change. This cap needs to be unscrewed. Again, it's got a hex on top of it. You need to find a crescent wrench or an open end or a socket, whatever you have. Turn the head here counterclockwise and just unscrew the head or the cap from the head very simply like this. And as you notice, we've got the cap and there's a spring inside that holds the element. And you reach in here, there's a little bail on the element and you can pull the element off of the guide tube that's in there and you replace this element. As you notice, this has one of our geo seal, which is a square grommet. And then when you get the new element, of course, you take this and you put it in your pan to drain any residual oil that might be in it. The new element comes with the grommet already attached. What you got to do is just lube the grommet with a little bit of oil from your tank, or if you have a special lube you use, a CosmoLube, it'll lube it. You then install it. It's got four corners on it. You put it in down onto the guide tube. You can feel it. Just push it in. Put the spring back in the cap, and put the spring back in the element and on the cap, and we put it on and tighten up. There's also an O-ring on the cap. You just want to inspect, make sure it's not torn. We turn it on and we just tighten it up and pull it down as tight as we possibly can, and that's your element change. It's very simple, very quick. The RLT is a T-line medium pressure filter with a durable and compact design. It can handle flow ratings up to 70 gallon a minute and operating pressures up to 1,000 PSI. It's very simple to change. It would be hanging usually like this. And in this case, what we do is we take the bowl and unscrew the bowl very simply. Pull the bowl down. Now, of course, again, you're gonna have a bowl full of oil. So when you're pulling it down, you just gotta be a little bit careful pulling it down. Pull it down. Got an element that's got oil in it. Hopefully you got a pan under it. Clean out your bowl, dump all the oil out or whatever's in here. Some of them have drains on the bottom. That's a specialty item, but clean out the bowl with a nice clean rag and some cleaning fluid. Pull your old element off. Dispose of the element. This element has an O-ring seal internal. They come with the O-ring seal in it. And if you look up inside of this housing, you're going to have to do that. There's an O-ring in here and a backup ring. Just double check them to make sure that there's no cracks or splits in the O-ring and so we don't have any leaks. You take your new element, push it back up on the guide tube like that. Take your seal and take your bowl and put it up inside and just screw it back together and take it all the way down until it stops. Put a wrench on it and take it about a quarter turn and it's sealed in place. And that's your element change. It's very simple. Again, you got to remember that you have your machine shut down before you do this. And if you do have to drain it, make sure you drain it. Or if you're below oil level and your reservoir is setting up, make sure you have a shutoff valve that shuts off the oil from the reservoir to the filter so you don't drain the reservoir. The KF30 is a base ported pressure filter. It can handle flow ratings up to 100 gallon per minute and operating pressures up to 3,000 pounds. These are static operating pressures, not fatigue pressures.
Today we're going to be changing elements in the GKF30. This being a base ported element, there are a couple things that we do differently. So first, we will take the bleed plug in the cap to help alleviate the pressure in the housing. So that will help the pressure internally release before we change the filter itself. And we want to actually, even though it's a base ported filter, we still want to drain the fluid before we change the element. So we'll remove the drain plug in the base, in the cap here. And the fluid will drain out from here. And once fluid stops coming out, we can use a torque wrench. GKF30 are usually torqued to 100 psi, 100 pounds on the cap. So you want to use the torque wrench accordingly to remove the cap. And once that's off, you will take the spring and the cap from the element. And with the GLC element, you don't have to use any twisting motion. You can just put your fingers in there and plug it out. And this will be the element you will be changing. So you can just take a clean rag, clean that off, wipe off any excess fluid over here, and take out a clean element and put that back in. And you just want to make sure the orientation of the GeoSeal grommet is sitting correctly with the fitting inside. Just a firm push, and then we carefully put the block, the cap inside the grommet, and the spring inside the cap. And we replace the cap of the housing. And again, depends on the customer, the pressure for the cap may be different. It may, usually it's 100 pound, but it could be more. It could be less, depends on the application. So you just want to use a torque wrench to make sure that the pressure is accurate. So once that's tightened down, we want to replace the drain plug, and then the bleed plug. And then we connect the inlet outlet back in, and the element is changed. So that's all three elements changed. I hope you find the video to be helpful. If you have any questions, please do not hesitate to contact our inside sales and tech support. Thank you for your time and hope you enjoy your day.